Hey guys, I'm the Sky Spire, and welcome back to my Let's Play of Pikmin 2. Last time, we entered the Frontier Cavern at the end of the Valley of Repose and finished the first sub-level. Today, we're going to continue our way through the Frontier Cavern, this cavern that really just was my last really big memory of Pikmin 2. We're going to hopefully get further down this cavern, finishing it, not entirely sure, but let's see how close we can get now, shall we? So as you can tell, I'm still a little sick, but let's press on. I can press on with being sick. I can do two at one. I'm a multitasker. Oh man, I don't know if there's a buried treasure on that stump or anything. Apparently not. Okay, I'm gonna try to I have this little smoothie right here next to me, and earlier I couldn't really drink cold drinks, but now I could. But now I can. I can drink smoothies. Oh no, yellow. Did he eat it? Oh, kill him! Yeah, buddy. I was trapped in a corner. That cannonball was heading for me. That bulb orb was coming after me. Bang. Alright, hold on. Can we by any chance route this back to you? Because that would be awesome. And, oh, or we just have enough Pikmin that... Ha! And then it just crashes into your dead body. And we didn't have any Pikmin die. That's awesome. Okay, let's have the rest of our guys just charge this snowball board. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Yeah, buddy. We're doing really good. Oh, we have another decorated cannon beetle. Okay, oh god. Okay, I was scared that if they wouldn't make it through. Okay, good. Okay, sneak up behind him. And everybody charge. Hopefully we can kill him. Yeah, buddy. Doing really, oh, but. We have two treasures. Look at that. We have a present from Santa, and then Santa also left his shoe behind just because. Very festive. Not to mention the very snow-like theme of the Frontier Cavern. It looks like it's Christmas. Speaking of Christmas,
come on.
Oh wow, okay, fine, we're okay with that. You know how the DL6 incident in Phoenix, right? Like, you know how it took place in Christmas and stuff? I hope I'm not, like, majorly spoiling any of you here. It shouldn't be, but I just remember in the Phoenix Wright movie, you're not fine, just everybody charge everything. I just remember in the Phoenix Wright movie, there was this, like, one scene where Phoenix would, like, interrogate a witness saying, "So, when you say it was the night of Christmas Eve, or the midnight after Christmas Eve, that would mean it's Christmas, right?" And it was so funny because as soon as he said Christmas, everybody in the courtroom just fell over like it was a cartoon. Like, they were like, "Oof!" And it was, like, so funny because it's a realistic, pretty, serious to an extent setting. But it was so funny because it's like, oh god, well, everybody's gonna collapse over like it's a cartoon. I just thought that was so funny. especially since I made a comment on the video saying, like, everybody everywhere falls over, and, like, freaking, like, that got so many likes. Icon of Progress? I want to see the naming idea behind that. But yeah, I just thought that was so funny, and I don't know, all this Christmas stuff is reminding me of it. Right now, it's, where are there 8 Pikmin? That's weird. Right now, it's a couple of days before Christmas. Christmas is, I don't know about coming up, it's still November. It's late November, but I mean, it's enough to give me the mindset that Christmas is coming up, because I love Christmas. Christmas is my favorite holiday of the year. Halloween is fun, I know. I did a Luigi's Mansion Let's Play for Halloween, but hey. Sorry, hiccup. But I do love myself some Christmas. It's so festive, just seeing everybody running around with the lights. I don't know, it's kind of one of those things. Like, I really love the blue light that comes in from the sun, like when you, or through your windows. It's like blue light as opposed to like the orange light that comes from your light bulb. Whoa, this is an interesting sub-level. I am a fan of, like, that blue light, you know? So, I don't know, I always just love opening the windows, and just, if I can, and I mean, oh, buddy. Okay, fine, we'll have Louie come in with everything else, I suppose. Oh, hey, hey! Actually, before we press on, I want to introduce you guys to this. Check it out. It's a bulwarp, but with a leaf on it. If we kill it, let's actually kill this bulwarp right here. I know, why would you want to? It's so adorable, isn't it? Oh. Wow! I think we've just demonstrated another ability of the white Pikmin. I did say that there was one more ability of the white Pikmin that we haven't shown off. The creature showed symptoms of poisoning after consuming the white Pikmin. Perhaps white Pikmin excrete a poisonous substance when chewed. How fascinating. Yeah, and I think we're gonna get another tutorial right now. Yes, we are. The offspring of that big thing. The confused bulwarp has fallen in with the Pikmin. They appear to coexist peacefully. Strange, this bulwarp is a leaf sprouting from his spine, much like the leaf on a Pikmin's head. So, let's whistle everything here since everybody's in chaos. Okay, guys. Okay. So, as you can see here, we had 97, now we have 99, and if we would look in this, corner right here where we see the Pikmin, we have this bulwarp thing as well. We have two of these guys. These guys are Bulbmen. You'll sometimes see Bulbmen in dungeons, and they will be awesome. Bulbmen are basically, actually, let's, group them again. Bulbmen are basically the, come on. Bulbmen are, you'll sometimes find them in caves with their mother, and if you, kill their mother, what? What the hell? What the heck? No! Oh my god! What the heck? Where did you come from? Oh my god, why? Did not see that at all. Wait, what the heck? Why is there still a life meter? Is that a glitch? I can't finish my explanation! Anyway, Bulbmen will sometimes appear with their mother, and if you kill their mother, you can whistle back their offspring, and they are very, very interesting. Okay, that is a glitch. They had a little bit of health remaining when they shouldn't have. Oh, God. Okay, both of our Bulbmen are still alive. That's all that matters. I just saw a bunch of red ghosts. Anyway. Okay, so let's group them now. Gosh, come on. Okay, yellows, go with Olimar. Louis, I suppose you can take everybody else. Or don't take the reds, just take the Bulbmen and the whites. Yeah. Alright. So, I think, I haven't shown off, though, what's so special about the Bulbmen. Yes, they're Pikmin that you find in caves, once again. But what makes them so interesting? Well, let's throw Bulbmen into electricity. And yeah, oh, come on! Do we really just have to have a Bulbmen get eaten? Did we just have to have that happen? Oh god, why the heck did I throw a red Pikmin into electricity? Where's my yellows? There they are, come on. Come on. Okay. Now, think of something stupid. Bulbmen, as you saw, are immune to electricity. They can fight electricity. Also, yeah, you can't whistle back Pikmin from being electrocuted. Electricity is instant death, like right away. No whistling, no instant death. But yeah, Bulbmen are immune to that. What's better is Bulbmen are also immune to poison. What's better, Bulbmen, they're not gonna show it off, but Bulbmen are also immune to fire. Bulbmen are immune to every single thing. Bulbmen are just immune to every single element, period. And that is so amazing, because they're so rare, and let's not even get started with what this means for the just Bulbmen evolutionary line. Let's not even get started with that. The fact that they're Bulbor Pikmin, and they are immune to every single element. That's just really fascinating, in reality, if you really think about it. Anyway, oh, it's so sad that we had that stupid death. Can we throw Pikmin right in your head? Come on, please, let's try to. Come on, yeah, buddy, okay. God, that was retarded. This sublevel was awful. This sublevel was absolutely awful. Lost a Bulbmen. That was a very clean bite by the Bulbmen there. Here we go. But yeah, so Bulbmen are really cool. And look at that, they just walk on two legs, just like pop, 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 pop. I'm sorry, but when like any creature walks Wooper style with just two legs and no arms, it just looks adorable and helpless. Alright, let's see here. We have the fleeting art form. Oh, you have more? So I suppose that means buried treasure. Oh, we didn't even go this way yet. Oh, God. We have Ivory Candy Pop Buzz. One thing I should mention about the Bulbmen in advance, though. Like, if you're thinking about, like, the onions and blah, blah, blah. No, Bulbmen can't even be brought out of caves. They have to stay in caves, which is pretty sad. So you can only, when you get a Bulbmen, you can only stick with it for the cave that you find it in, which is pretty sad. Oh yeah, we can just escape from sub-level 3 if you want. It's interesting, in case you're the retreating source. I've been really serious this episode, I don't know. I haven't made any bad jokes. Alright, sorry, sickness, man. I think I'll get back into it, come on. So because you can't take Bulbmen out, you might want to like convert them into a white Pikmin or something, so that like right there, so that they, you know, so that you can actually take them out of the dungeon. But hey, where is this treasure? Come on, I want to see that love tester needle. But I just forgot that it was actually a love tester. I want to see that love tester needle just rise up, go like, oh my god, love. It's interesting. I mean, this is a really big sub level, but. Okay, so will it rise more if you go down to the southern part of it? Of this level? Yes, it will. Okay. Oh, what the heck? That's not right. Come on. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so white Pikmin, can you bury it up? Whoa, okay. Yeah, egg coming down from the ceiling. Not exactly... A little terrifying. Alright, there we go. Oh! I do hope we can get more Bulbmen though, because they're a really interesting species. Alright, so I think... Actually, wait, what am I doing? Just disband everybody? Absolutely. Alright, so... Gosh, this cavern. I don't even remember a lot of the things about this cavern, because again, this is the last... My last experience with Pikmin 2 has been in this cavern. I don't really remember much about this place. The Gemstar Husband. Okay, that's weird. I wasn't aware that the two of you had this little weird relationship thing going on. Alright, let me take a quick little sip out of my little my mug. Hope you enjoy that really disturbing sipping sound. Oh, this is a very one-way sub. Oh, okay, we got an anode beetle. Is that what I think it is? I see a shadow up there. I don't think that's a... Okay, we have a violet candy pop, but that's not a swooping snitch bug, is it? It is a swooping snitch. Okay, never mind. I was thinking of another enemy, but no, it is a swooping snitch bug. Okay, so let's charge! Okay. Also, you're probably noticing with, like, the big elemental thing going on, like, with, like, all these dungeons having some sort of elemental danger, we're not really giving purple Pikmin a big shine, are we? But, yeah, I mean, oh, wait, what the heck? There's only one of them, it's not exactly a creative field like those guys up there. Come on, let's charge it, come on. But, yeah, so we're not really giving purple Pikmin their spotlight, which is a little sad, because they're amazing. Oh, there's the enemy I was thinking of. Hey, buddy. Okay, hold on, let's, whoa. Wait, yeah, okay, I think these guys are these guys what I'm thinking? Oh god, no, yeah, they carry your captain! I think these guys are what I'm thinking of. If I'm correct, and I might not be since, again, I don't remember most, really? Now my Wii remote sensor is what's weird. If I'm correct, these guys are careening dirigibugs. They will actually carry your captain up in the air and make you helpless, and maybe you can switch to the other captains, I'm not sure, but... Korean dirigibugs, or whatever these guys are called. I just remember these specific enemies. They're pretty weird, but... Alright, let's see here. What do we have? Okay, treasure? No. There's something close. Oh, okay, hey, buddy. It's like you just shout up to the ceiling, hey, thanks for that egg. Thanks for that egg. It's supposed to land on your head, yo fool. Alright, now. Oh. What the heck? Back here. What the heck? So is the treasure back here? Okay, hold on. Make up your mind. Oh, duh. I'm stupid. Oh, wait. I remember that. Okay. I remember this. Get it together, Sky. Get it together, Sky. Oh, we have another swooping stitch bug. Come on. Yeah, there we go. Not so tough now, are you? Whoa! Oh, did I just throw reds into the... Yeah, must have thrown reds into there. Let's actually retreat. Hold on. I think it's safer to just go in there with just yellows because then they just straight up cannot hurt us. And, oh yeah, sure, and Bulbman actually. Here, hey buddy, Bulbman. Bulbman. I kind of don't want to put you in danger. But at the same time, you're so awesome to not be put in danger. Wow, that's mean. You're saying that to an orphan. You're saying that to an orphan. You're evil. Alright, so let's see here. Okay. Anode Beetle, get over here. Okay, not one of them landed on his back. Come on. Come on. There. Come on. Yeah, there we go. That's what I'm talking about. Come on. Come on. Just storm it. Just storm it. Just storm it. Oh my god. We're such a small army. This is so hard. Okay. Come on. I believe in you. This is gonna take... You know, I might just speed this up. Alright, so we cleared up that area now, and, alright, so we got all this done with it. Just gotta say, all of these dead buddy. All of these dead beetle undersides, they're just so creepy, because, I mean, have you seen these beetle undersides in real life? OW! That did so much damage, come on! Okay, well, make sure that whatever captain is getting held by this thing. Oh my god, no. Stop. Stop. Just stop. Oh my god, are you joking? No, 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 no. I refuse. I refuse you to. Come on. No, I can save you. I can save you. I can save you. No, no, no. Ah, damn it. No! Oh my god. I think this is the first time we've ever had a captain at red health. Which is pretty crazy because. Come on! Wait, do we need to actually play as that captain and then, like, wriggle from his grasp? I don't know. What is this thing? Is this, like, a whistle? Innocence lost. Oh, this is the top of a Christmas tree. Okay, whistle. Oh, no, 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 no! Play as Louie again. Come on. You got this. Oh, my God! You have so little health! Freaking kidnapper? Pikmin napper? Not even Pikmin napper. Captain napper? Is that a thing? Actually, that is a thing. Like, the, like, captain of ships. That is a thing. I think right now I'm only gonna be- Oh, no, 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 no! Oh, my God. Trying to give me, like, 10 heart attacks here. I think now I'll only be playing as Louie because I do not want to leave him alone and have him be in danger. So let's just, yeah, not- Oh my gosh. That was such a ridiculous... That was such a ridiculous, what was I gonna say? Such a ridiculous, experience. Like, what the hell? So I caught, you know what? The ultimate remedy for cough. You like those really weird sipping noises, man. The omniscient spear. The omniscient spear. Absolutely. The omniscient spear. Can you see the thorns at the end? You see the gigantic stick? Yes, omniscient spear is what that is. okay. Daniel, sick of it. Come on, I gotta get my health better. Let's just jump and you gotta jump in all you guys. And that one, I love how that one red Pikmin also just took a ridiculous leap of faith. Alright, so I think, after this sub-level, I might end it off. I'm not too sure. I might not. Oh, hey! Oh, hell no! Whoa! Yeah! Wow! We got lots of candy pop buds, actually. Yeah, this floor! I think I actually legitimately remember this floor. This Mamuda! Oh my gosh! I miss you guys! So, Louie, where are you, buddy? I think there's a lot of things that need explaining. Well, let's just explain them in order. First of all, when we defeated the Mamuda, processing, how strange, this atypical metal object came from inside that bizarre being. It appears to be a giant metal hand. Perhaps it is an ancient work of art. Oh my god, so many things need explaining right now. Okay, first of all, Louie, get out. I said, Louie, get out. I wish we could throw captains like in Pikmin 3. Get out. Oh my god. What the heck, we only have two whites? Oh, duh, okay. The other thing that needs explaining. We threw a bunch of Pikmin in there, and now you see they're all buried in the ground, all flowers. That's what the Mamuda does. It doesn't actually kill Pikmin. It actually plants them into the ground and gives them all flowers. So it actually is a complete help, besides it whacking Louie in the face. It's actually a pretty big help. Now, Brute Knuckles. This object seems to replicate a humanoid fist, a glove much like it once lay in my junk hold. And here is that very glove. I have just found the missing rocket fist in my junk hold. Tap A three times to launch it. 1-2 punch. So now we have a very menacing little wallop to our punch. Let's just demonstrate with you with Louie, our best pal here. You can just press A 3 times. Bop bop. Yeah, it's still nothing. You still don't want to do a lot of punching, but hey, I mean, if you're gonna be throwing out these jabs, you might want to do it with some style, you know? Alright, now, I don't think, and I have completed this game, and I'm saying this, I don't think I've ever had a Pikmin, a captain die. I don't think I ever have. So, actually, let's take care of this Mamuda first. Let's do that. Come on. Come on, let's take this nice and slowly, buddy. People are... Well, it's good to know that every single one of our Pikmin is in the ground. Oh, what the heck? Wait, hold on, how'd we kill it? There was four Pikmin that were alive. That's amazing. Oh, God, there's a lot of Mamuda on this level. Okay, I think we're also starting to see the, What am I trying to say here? I think we're also about to see the water thread of this place. Yeah, there's a blue Dweevil over there. Yeah. Red Dweevil spit fire, blue Dweevils not so much. That's basically the philosophy. I think, what are we gonna want? Actually, wait, what color are these? That's violet. Okay, I wanna check these again, because, oh, isn't that a Lapis Lazuli candy pop bud? Yeah, okay. The whole deal with that is just in case you want blue Pikmin to deal with the watery Dweevil over there, you can have a blue candy pop bud. But I'm not gonna, or rather you can have blue Pikmin for that, but I'm not gonna bother. Oh my god, this is gonna be a really interesting, actually here, you guys probably want a better view. Let's get a better view of this. Look at this rainbow of Pikmin. This is gonna take a while actually, I'm gonna take another lovely sip of my... Can we just let go of it? No, we need to keep on... Can we hold A? No, we just need to keep on mashing it. Okay, so let's keep on mashing it. Let's keep on having these guys sprout it, and I'm going to take another sip. Gosh, every sip I take is amazing. I love this. Are you guys wondering what smoothie, like what kind of like flavor smoothie it is? Mama Sky has gone blender happy these days. And throws whatever she can find into a blender. Yes, that is where I'm going with this. Mama Sky one day got a blender, and then she got everything she could find in the kitchen, and then just threw it all in the blender. She just throws whatever she can find, but you know what? It always tastes good. Now I think she's putting a little more thought into it, but it's just hilarious how much stuff she just throws in there. Anyway, I'm gonna go out there with my Bulbmin and Red Pikmin. The reason why I didn't decide to bring Blue Pikmin in here is because of the Watery Dweebles. That's not what I'm trying to say. It's because the Watery Dweebles are actually really easy to beat. Just, oh crap, but the Mamoodas are in the same room! Let's do this, let's just take care of the Mamoodas. Thank you guys for being able to flowerize all of our Pikmin, but in reality, we really need you guys done. Come on, go on. Okay. Now, hopefully this Dweeble doesn't interfere. Don't interfere! Good, okay. Now we have a problem, which is sprouting the Pikmin again. I did not want to bring you guys with me. Okay. Now we need to pluck all of these Pikmin out of the ground. Oh, hey, that Bulbin turned into a flower. That's awesome. I really do like the idea of Mamoodas. Mamooda was originally a mini-boss, a secret mini-boss in Pikmin 1. And it was really interesting. Everybody was like, you just went up to this slope and you just found a Mamooda there who would just knock all your Pikmin to the ground. It's a very interesting creature. And if you can tell by this point, if you can't tell by this point, the Pikmin series is one of my favorite series to display theories in. I mean, Zelda, I have constant theories. I've come up with one theory that, I mean, I haven't even heard anywhere else Zelda related. I'm not gonna say what it is yet, but when the time's more relevant, I'll mention it. Oh, wait, I wanna switch this. I don't want Louie to get in there with the Dweebles. No, hold on. Let's do this. All right, Louie, you take all this. Alright. So, we're gonna. Sorry. Gotta love those noises. Alright, Alright, let's hope we don't have too hard of a time against this guy. Come on! Good. See, you don't really need to worry about bringing blue Pikmin into this dungeon, or even converting them into blue Pikmin with the Lapis Lazuli the Candy Pop Bun. Oh, really? Is that what we're doing now? You're carrying the Mamoodas away? Oh, there we go! Ah! Just whistle them away. Okay, if they get hit by the water, just whistle them, and they're fine. They're back to brand new. Pikmin are suffering. And literally that one Pikmin is suffering off in the left. Come on, let's take... Oh, what the heck? Okay, well, if you want me to help, run back here. Okay. I mean, I know that's not how it works, but come on. There we go. Yeah, these guys are not really too much of a problem. But yeah, there are actually, like, multiple different kinds of, Dweebles, which is really cool. Bop. All right. And think about it, we were once in this like very festive Christmas like frontier cavern. Now we're in like a very flower garden like area, which is very fitting of the Mamooda to be in a place like this. I'm just gonna say that much. If there was a golden candy pop bud, I would definitely convert some red Pikmin, but there's an ivory. We have so few what am I trying? God, my aim is awful. Oh, well, apparently I got five in. But we lost white Pikmin and yellow Pikmin as well, so let's just, let's resprout some of them. Alright. Anyway, guys, so I think I might end it off here for this time. So, we had an interesting run through a couple of more sub-levels of the Frontier Cavern. Interesting little place we got ourselves through, and we can exit as well if we want to, but let's continue on. Next time, we're going to be continuing through hopefully the last sub-levels of the Frontier Cavern. I think we will, considering how many more sub-levels of this place is left. Anyway, guys, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more on Pikmin and all other things. All other things Nintendo. I'm the Sky Spire, and until then...